Hello, everybody. I'd like to begin by asking you to please take out your mobile phones. Yes, I know, this is not a request you normally hear at the beginning of any talks. Normally, if you ask, put them away. But please, don't be shy. Take them out and hold them up. Now, there's quite a lot of rustling, but already I can see that virtually everyone in this room has a mobile phone. Now, what you have in your hands is essentially a small, personal supercomputer. Did you know that even the oldest models have more number crunching power than the supercomputers at NASA, which first put man on the moon? These massive advancements in technology have trickled down into every aspect of our lives. From the way we communicate, such as use of social media and the smartphone, to the way we entertain ourselves, such as Netflix, 7D movie experiences, and virtual reality. And also how we learn, such as use of the Kindle and web pages and websites, and even how we diagnose and treat illness. Modern medical advancements help millions of people live longer, healthier, and more productive lives. Technological advancements in the medical industry are on the forefront of technological change. 20 years, 16 years, 10 years. These are the times to create the vaccines for polio, typhoid fever, and mumps. 9 months. That's how long it took to create the COVID-19 vaccine. The great growling engine of change, technology, made this possible. This massive advancement in production time represents the advancement of the medical industry. Modern medical advancements have helped millions of people live longer, healthier, and more productive lives. The world as we know today is changing at an unprecedented rate. It has said that the world has changed more in the last decade than it has in the last century. Humanity today is at a crossroads. We face both opportunities and challenges as a result of these powerful emerging technologies. Technological growth is exponential, and it is feared that within a few decades, machine intelligence will surpass human intelligence, leading to a singularity, a change so rapid, so profound, that it ruptures the fabric of human history. Amid this ever-evolving technological landscape, whilst many of us are still grappling with uncertainties, if we look closer, we may find unique opportunities. From the creation of the first antibiotics to the creation of the first vaccines to decoding the human genome, humans have been master creators since we first walked the earth. From tailor-made faces to tailor-made babies, advancements in technology are slowly moving from a sci-fi concept to a reality, which will slowly turn into a tsunami, which will take over every aspect of our lives. In 1976, Dr. Christian Bernard performed the world's first successful human-to-human heart transplant. Do any of you know how long that patient survived? Only 18 days. Fast forward to the present day, and we've seen remarkable growth in this industry. Almost 4,000 heart transplants take place each year, with the average life expectancy having risen to 20 years. With all this talk about advancement in the medical industry and the future, one can only wonder where we will be 100 years from now. Now, Darth Vader to me represents the advancement of the medical industry, and here's why. He had 100% burns, multi-organ failure, quadriplegia, some psychological issues, some minor problems, and of course, asthma. Not formally diagnosed, but you get the joke. And yet, through machine learning, biotechnology, and a bunch of sensors, he was not only able to live life to the fullest, but also rule the galaxy. Just as Darth Vader's life was radically transformed by advancements in technology, we too are on the cusp of a medical revolution that will reshape our understanding of what is possible. Just recently, I underwent a hernia operation, and it was successful with just 3 minor holes on my stomach, and I was back home the next day and back to school just a week later. Quite a contrast to what I would have experienced only 30 years ago. People often say, why reinvent the wheel? They are of course referring to why try to improve something that's already almost perfect. But the wheel of 4200 BC looks very different than the wheel of 2024. The wheel needed reinventing to better suit newer purposes. And just like that, medicine needs reinventing to better serve humanity. Just as medical technology has slowly advanced beyond the realms of what we originally thought possible, we are beginning to witness a future where medical technology may advance even further. Imagine a world where diseases are detected at their earliest stages, far before symptoms even appear. A world where personalized medicine is the norm, catered to each individual's unique genetic makeup. By analyzing a patient's genome, we are able to discover genetic predispositions to certain diseases and develop targeted therapies to help prevent their onset. By preventing these targeted therapies, by analyzing a patient's genome, we are also able to help advance medical technology far beyond what it currently is. These levels of personalized care will revolutionize healthcare industry. Now imagine a future where medical technology is as simple as tapping your fingers. I would invite you all to please close your eyes. And this is mandatory, so please actually close your eyes. But imagine waking up in a futuristic medical facility. Imagine the pristine white walls around you. Imagine the futuristic sharp blue glow of holographic screens. In this world, instead of traditional medicine, like pills and vaccines, medicine is instead administered through the usage of nanobots, tiny robotic particles that navigate throughout your bodies, repairing damaged cells, reversing the effects of diseases, and even slowing down aging. Now imagine, if you can, shrinking down to a microscopic size and traveling down your bloodstream. As you travel, you witness other nanobots at work, repairing damaged tissues, clearing out blockages, and restoring balance to your body. Now imagine, this will be the last imagine, don't worry, but imagine being able to communicate with these nanobots simply by using your thoughts. Just by simply thinking about your desired health outcome, the nanobots receive your instructions and work diligently to fulfill them. Now while this may seem like the plot of some sci-fi film or a future 1,000 years away, advancements in medical technology are suggesting that we are moving closer and closer to such possibilities. World history has witnessed many innovative ideas that first caused skepticism, but later revolutionized industries. The path from creation to global recognition is often fraught with difficulties that are surmountable with persistence and innovation, the hallmarks of transformative ideas. However, as we delve deeper into this realm of personalized medicine and genetic manipulation, we encounter a set of challenges. No one likes challenges. Challenges are like roadblocks. When we encounter them, we get the impulse to go away from them, turn around them. But if we instead theme them, sort them, organize them into tiny little boxes in our mind, and then solve them, even the most arduous challenges can eventually be beaten. One of the key challenges we face is ensuring the ethical and responsible usage of such technologies. As Bernard Shaw once said, atrocities are not less atrocities when they occur in medical laboratories and are called research. As medicine continues to advance and evolve, we encounter more difficulties that demand our attention. Privacy, understanding, and fairness take center stage in this brave new world. Privacy, the cornerstone of personal autonomy, is under threat as we accumulate vast amounts of sensitive personal data, including sensitive genetic information. We must safeguard individuals' privacy from unauthorized access and misuse, and this becomes paramount as we accumulate vast more and more, as we increasingly accumulate amounts of data. As the saying goes, your data is your digital identity, and we must protect it fiercely. Proclaiming that you don't care about personalized medicine and medical confidentiality because you have no medical secrets, there's no different than stating you don't care about disease prevention because you have no diseases right now. Privacy becomes one of the main issues that we face when ensuring the arrival of these advancements in technology to this new world. But privacy is just one piece of the puzzle. We must ensure, with the potential for genetic manipulation and invasive procedures, we must ensure that individuals have a comprehensive understanding of the risks and benefits involved. Informed consent becomes a bedrock on which we build the foundation for these advancements. As former Secretary General of the United Nations, Kofi Annan, once said, "Knowledge is power. Information is liberating. Education is the premise of progress in every society, in every family." We must ensure that individuals have knowledge so that they are able to make decisions for their own bodies. Quality is also another major concern. With the potential, with, well, medical technology promises to revolutionize the medical health outcomes, we must ensure that they do not inadvertently widen the gap between the haves and the have-nots. Factors such as cost, geography, and socioeconomic status can create disparities in access. We must strive to bridge these gaps and ensure that everyone, regardless of background or circumstance, is able to effectively use these technologies and gain access to the advancements in the future. However, with great power comes great responsibility. Well, as we begin to blur the line between man and God, we must harness the potential of these technologies in an ethical and responsible manner. The de-extinction of animals, the alteration of the human genome to create perfect babies, the creation of arthropods, other biomedical marvels, such as artificial organs, are all reshaping our understanding of what it means to be human. However, laws and regulations are essential as they will be the moral compass that guides these advancements towards the future. Without a firm ethical foundation, we risk creating a world where everyone is expected to conform to the narrow definition of perfection. While technology propels us forward, we must ensure that rather than becoming a tool for exclusion, it serves a common good and helps advance these efforts towards the future. The burning question that arises is, will we allow this great growling engine of change to destroy us or deliver us? Will our generation be the one to rein in the power of these technologies to save us, or unleash an Armageddon that will destroy the human race? Thank you.